The idea of going under anesthesia for surgery can be worrisome for many of us. So I'm heading straight to the source to find out how anesthesia really works and why doctors don't want you to worry if you have to have surgery.
So I'm putting on some scrubs to head to the OR so I can learn from an expert.
I'm here with anesthesiologist Dr. Candido. Now, we've all heard of anesthesia, but are there different types of anesthesia?
You're absolutely correct, Jane. Most people have the perception that anesthesia means rendering them completely asleep for surgery or for some procedure, but in fact, we have a lot of ways to anesthetize the body. There's a general anesthetic which knocks or renders patients completely asleep for surgery. We have regional anesthesia, which is like a nerve block, spinal or epidural. We have local anesthesia, which is infiltration where the surgeon may supply a local anesthetic directly at the targeted site. And we have monitored anesthesia care or twilight sedation or conscious sedation, where we just put people into a twilight type of sleep.
Why do you have to be completely unconscious for some surgeries?
Sometimes the surgeon has to have access to the deeper recesses of the body, the organs, the cavities and so forth. So that demands complete muscular relaxation, and we can't do that in an awake patient.
Now that makes people nervous to be completely asleep, out of it, out of control. What do you say to ease their concerns?
Well, what I tell patients, and this is my standard routine, is that anesthesia has become eminently safer for everybody because we've taken great pains to control these vital functions as well as to monitor what we do. We have the best technology available in the world right here.
So since we're in the OR, will you show me how it works?
Absolutely, my pleasure.
We recruited a volunteer to be our stand-in patient.
We've got our lovely volunteer here.
Indeed.
Tomasa, she's gonna be our patient for the day, but not really going under anesthesia. What's the first thing you do before you put somebody under general anesthesia?
Well, the procedure is typically commenced with an intravenous. Every patient that comes into this room has a free-flowing intravenous line attached to a bag of saline or some equivalent solution. Usually we've given the patient a couple of drugs that will quell their anxiety, reduce their stress level, and then we assess them and make sure that they are stable from a cardiovascular perspective. And we do that by applying some of our tools here. We have a blood pressure cuff that will go on one arm.
So when someone's asleep, what are you monitoring?
Well, monitoring their physiological functions, their heart rate, their blood pressure, their oxygen saturation, their end-expired carbon dioxide, their temperature.
How do they come out? Do you wake them up, like jiggle them a little and wake up?
Well, it's not as simple as just flicking a switch like a light switch. Essentially, what we do is the process of, we use a term called titration, which means to gradually or slowly turn off our gas until the body resumes its normal functioning and takes over the control again spontaneously of breathing.
What's the takeaway that we should have from this conversation so we don't have concerns?
Anesthesia is thousands of times safer right now in 2017 than ever in the history of the world. And I would say have confidence. Go forth, ask questions, but also be honest with your anesthesiologist.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Yeah. Thank you so much.
There you have it, a closer look at how anesthesia works. For more information on how other medical procedures work, check out our website, livinghealthytv.com.